If you find that you need to recuse yourself, you're supposed to immediately disclose in writing the nature and the extent of the interest that you have. Which, when you recused yourself, you just put financial. Well, yes. That's not, that doesn't go into the nature and the extent. You know, you need to say,
at the time,
well,
that's what I was told I was supposed to do. That's exactly, I filled
the
form out.
But these were the,
Let's keep on point.
Well, that's, I'm trying to
close your book for the other stuff. Focus on this.
Okay.
So that we're only focused on what we can do. Reliving the past, this isn't the right forum. You know, there's other forums for that. You know, here, let's do, you know, look at the rules of the right.
Okay, I think we need to make sure that we follow the rules and the regulations that are set out by the state. The problem, if we don't do that, and it hasn't been done in the past, is that it could come back and bite us, and actually bite the Board of Commissioners, if it's not done right.
And they can make us, right.
Is this the state's rules?
No, this is our own stuff. This is put out. And so this is the other thing.
So, do we have a copy of the state's rules?
Don't you have one of these? Yeah, I've got the rule. I can bring that up. But let me tell you a little bit about this, because y'all haven't. I'm going to stay away from the other. This was put out in 2000. So, this has been around for a while. And it was written by Ken Girard. And it tells you how you're supposed to conduct yourself when you have a conflict.
You indicated it's not in conformity with state law currently.
I'm saying that essentially they're the same, but the state law is more strict, and I think the law says
that doesn't make sense.
I think
essentially the same.
Let me finish. You keep interrupting. I think the law, from what I remember, the law says that we can have these rules. But if these rules don't come up to the states, then the state rules prevail. So they could be tougher. And yeah, I can dig through some of this and find it in a minute. But I haven't even gotten to this yet.
We'll get to it.
Okay. You're supposed to immediately disclose, and this was in 2000. You immediately disclose the nature and extent of such an interest in writing to the governing authority. Of the local governing authority of the local government. And then you disqualify yourself. And then you take no other action on behalf of yourself or the person or the entity that you got a conflict with. That means you don't make motions concerning that. You don't vote on it. In the past, that has happened. As I said, this is, I mean, you made it a personal attack on me with saying that I'm
with focusing.
But what I'm getting at is our own attorney has said that what we've done is wrong. We all got a letter saying it's wrong. The common cause says that it's unethical, you know, not to go by this, and possibly illegal. It's a misdemeanor.
I didn't get a letter about that. I got a letter about the sunshine law.
No, you didn't get a letter about this. But I'm talking
about. You
just
said we all got a letter about it.
No, I
meant
the sunshine law.
Yeah.
From Ken Girard was about the open meetings.
Right.
Okay. And as far as I'm concerned, I think we all pretty well understand that.
Ma'am. Back up 1 second. You said I made a personal attack on you. Let me tell you, you went around behind my back to everybody in this room floor talking about how I shouldn't be vice chairman because my dad was having problems with the bank. So don't talk to me about making personal attacks, okay?
Okay. Just trying to. Oh, do you want the state Well, the bottom line is, I just want to, is what you said.
Come into compliance.
I want this board agree. In compliance.
And I have absolutely no...
And if it takes going through...
If I understood everything that you were saying...
My problem is, I don't think, and my problem is, I'm not sure if you understand that as chairman, and maybe a good review of...
I think you're doing that with all of us, because I don't know that we are an appointed board. We do the best that we can with the direction of our staff. We are not, you excluded, attorneys, and we are guided by the staff. The staff is the one that directs us to the best of their knowledge with the rules and procedures. That's what I have always done. And what I consider myself is a community servant, 100%. I am here only to serve my community, nothing else. I have no aspirations of political gain. I am not looking for any office. And if there is somebody that's more worthy and could do a better job, which I have always said every time my appointment has come up, they need to put that person in here. But if there is not another person, I have always said that I will do that. That's how I have rolled from three different commissioners. Because when I was up for appointment, every one of these commissioners has asked me, do you want to continue doing this community service? And my standard answer is, if you have someone else who could do the job better, put that person in. But if you don't, yes, I will gladly continue. But this is all community service to me. It's no aspiration of doing anything else but community service. So, and being the chairman, what I do as the chairman is I preside over the meeting. I try to conduct the meeting and keep it going on. We get paid no different. We have no more recommendation power. It is just to preside over the meeting. That's what my job is. So bringing this to our knowledge, to me, is as much your job as it is anyone else's. And we look for the direction from the staff to help us. I have never been told all of this. I have done what I've been directed to do all along. I have never not done what I have been told to do.
Well,
and I have not been the chairman the whole 14 years either.
No,
most of that I sat in the same chair you sat. Yeah. This is only the second tenure of being a chairperson that I have had. Okay. And I 100%, I want to go, I am a, if anyone that knows me, I am a rule player. And I am a rule player to the end. In fact, my children would tell you they don't like what a rule player I am, or my husband, because that's how much of a rule player I am. And
no, I didn't bring this back to Pam. Pam was doing this.
You started the whole damn thing.
Let me throw one thing out there. If our staff does provide to new members, we provide that little summary document from Ken Gerard's office. Just put it on the table. If at any time in the future the Planning Commission wanted him or someone from his office to come back in and give a walkthrough of that document, let me know. I'd be more than happy to do that.
Actually, I would like that very much. I think that's in order.
I think given the issues that have come up, it would make a lot of sense for him to come to us and, you know, present to us the things that we need to be considering with regard to sunshine laws that are commonly missed or areas where you can get into trouble.
Are you talking about me? Me presenting?
No.
Ken Gerard.
Oh, okay.
Sorry, yeah. I'm not going to give you the mic for that.
No.
I like things to move. but I do want us to be in compliance. And, you know, when it comes to conflicts, he can do it at the same time. you know, I'm more than willing to give up a night of my time so that we can all go through it and make sure that if there are any common pitfalls, you know, areas of concern, that we address it.
And I think that's a good idea. And I think it'll do us all some good. This is, one thing you can do is read the Georgia Code, like you said, and this is it right here.
I think it would, we would be better served
to
have him come here.
I would actually like if he could sit on, in on a few of our meetings.
That's not a bad idea.
No, that's not a bad idea either.
Because I think that will avoid a lot of challenges.
What's that gonna do with, is that a possibility to get that done? Or is that gonna be a money issue?
I got the money to cover that. That's it. We had actually, last week or the week before, he gave us a, from, to the staff, he provided a training session on open meetings where we talked about notice, talked about agendas, we talked about minutes, we hit the three main highlights of that requirement from staff level. Those are the things, in my view, the staff are responsible for. I didn't want to bring the planning commission back because I feel like you have other responsibilities and I can bring him to this meeting in the future and have him customize that presentation for the things the planning commission needs to worry about. And so far I've only seen nine heads, so I'm going to assume you're comfortable with me just moving forward.
Yes.
Doing that.
Did you make a motion? I'd like to make a motion that Ken Gerard comes and sits in on.
I try to get him to attend a few meetings and also
several meetings, and would also like him to cover any sunshine rules or any other rules or regulations that we need to come into compliance with.
Second.
All in favor? Motion carries.